Shalawami Spacha. What's up, fam? Bring you another book. This one's called Discourse on the Evidences of the American Indians Being the Descendants of the Lost Tribes of Israel by Mordecai Noah. The book is from 1837. We're going to go through a few pages. All right, we're going to start you off on page 4. Check this out. And what are the evidences of their existence at this day? An earthquake may shake and overturn the foundations of a city. The avalanche may overwhelm the hamlet. And the crater of a volcano may pour its lava over fertile plains and populous villages. But a whole nation cannot vanish from the sight of the world without leaving some traces of its existence, some marks of habits and customs. It is a singular fact that history is exceedingly confused, or rather, I may say dark, respecting the ultimate dispersion of the tribes among the cities of the Medes. The last notice we have of them is from the second book of Esdras, which runs thus, "Whereas thou sawest another peaceable multitude, these are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea. Salmanasser, king of Assyria, led away captive, and he carried them over the waters, so they came unto another land. They took this counsel among themselves, that they would leave the multitude of the heathen and go into a further country wherein never mankind dwelt, that they might there keep their statutes which they never kept in their own land. And there was a great way to go, namely a year and a half." Alright, we're going to continue on in the middle of page 5. "There is no doubt in the march from the Euphrates to the northeast coast of Asia, many of the tribes hesitated in pursuing the journey. Some remained in Tartary. Many went into China. Avila states in his History of China that the Jews had been living in that kingdom for more than 600 years. He might with greater probability have said 1,600 years. He speaks of their being very numerous in some of the provinces, and having synagogues in many of the great cities, especially in that of Henan and its metropolis, Kai Tung Fu, where he represents them to have a magnificent place of worship and a repository of the holy volume, adorned with richly embroidered curtains in which they preserve in an ancient Hebrew manuscript roll. They know but little of the Mosaic Law and only repeat the names of David, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob in a Hebrew letter written by the Jews of Cochin China to their brethren at Amsterdam. They give as the date of their retiring into India, the period when the Romans conquered the Holy Land. It is clearly evident, therefore, that the tribes in their progress to a new and undiscovered country left many of their numbers," top of page 6, "left many of their numbers in China and Tartary, and finally reached the Straits of Bering, the Bering Straits, where no difficulty prevented their crossing to the northwest coast of America, a distance less than 30 miles, interspersed with the Copper Islands, probably frozen over and reaching our continent, spread themselves in the course of 2,000 years to Cape Horn, the more hardly keeping to the north to Labrador, Hudson's Bay, and Greenland, the more cultivated fixing their residence in the beautiful climate and rich possessions of Central America, Mexico, and Peru." Alright, we're going to continue on. Bottom of page 6. "Kings, conquerors, nations, Christians, Mohammedans, and heathens all had united in the design of destroying the nation. But they never despaired. They knew that they were the elect and chosen of the Lord. The oath that he never would abandon his people had been fulfilled for 3,500 years." Alright, we're going to jump around. We'll go to middle of page 17. "It would occupy a greater space of time than I can afford to trace a similitude between all the Indian rites and religious ceremonies and those of the Jewish nation. In their birth, in their separation after the birth of their children, in their daily prayers and sacrifices, in their festivals, in their burials, in the employment of mourners, and in their general belief, I see a close analogy and intimate connection with all the ceremonies and laws which are observed by the Jewish people, making a true allowance for what has been lost and misunderstood in the course of upwards of 2,000 years. A general belief exists among most travelers that the Indians are descendants of the missing tribes. Top of page 8. Their hospitality might be quoted as examples among the most liberal of the present day. These were a different class from those found on the Sandwich and Fiji Islands. The red man of America, bearing as they do the strongest marks of Asiatic origin, have for more than 2,000 years, and divided as they are in upwards of 300 different nations, been remarkable for their intellectual superiority, their bravery in war, their good faith in peace, and all the simplicity and virtues of their patriarchal fathers, until civilization, as it is called, had rendered them familiar with all of the vices which distinguish the present era, without being able to enforce any of the virtues which are the boast of our present enlightened times. It is, however, in the religious beliefs and ceremonies of the Indians that I propose showing some of the evidences of their being, as it is believed, the descendants of the dispersed tribes. This opinion is founded, first, their belief in one God. Second, in the computation of time by their ceremonies and the new moon. Third, in their divisions of the year in four seasons, answering to Jewish festivals of the Feast of Flowers, the Day of Atonement, the Feast of Tabernacle, and other religious holy days. Fourth, in the erection of a temple after the manner of our temple, and having an Ark of the Covenant, and also the erection of altars. Fifth, by the division of nation into tribes, with a chief over Grand Sachem at their head. Sixth, by their laws of sacrifice, ablutions, marriages, ceremonies in war and peace, and the prohibition of eating certain things, fully carrying out the Mosaic instructions. And that's all we have for this book. More to come. Stay up, fam. Shalom.